which I think we will. If the girls have got more downloads, I feel like I've been hit with a sledgehammer, to be honest.
I think we're going to do well. That's it. Nothing more to say. I just think we're going to do well.
I'm feeling really confident.
For the boys, 3,951 apps downloaded. Karen, what's the final figure for the girls?
10,667. Did you know that you did that face when you were disappointed?
Absolutely.
Somebody stole my chocolate face.
That, I think, sums up exactly how me and the rest of the team felt. It was horrific.
How does it, I mean, the app market is huge, and you've adjudicated on the Appy Awards for the best apps. I mean, you've had to run your eye over apps. How did theirs actually compare as an industry?
What they got, I mean, they didn't do the market research bit, but they picked up quite quickly that most apps are used for time wasting.
Yeah.
And most apps are free. And I think they found something which was quirky, that was something that, and what you're really looking for is something that could go viral and something that you really would show your mates down the pub and that would say, look at this, it's just a bit of fun. And I think they found that. I think they found a good name that was easily searchable. They just made one fatal mistake, which was it wasn't global.
Why do you think they went wrong?
We got so carried away with the theatrics, the comedy, putting on the show, that you actually forgot that you were trying to reach a global audience with a global product.
You did get the push, but Leon diced with death, particularly what I feel is going to be a famous moment within this series, this horrendous wobble in the boardroom.
I'd like to bring back Alex and Jim.
I'm not the person you should be bringing in, so you needed to change your decision. Sure.
Do you want me to change? Is that
change? Actually, you're the man. You're bringing in.
It's Jim. Obvious.
Okay.
It's obvious.
Jim, yeah, it's obvious. Okay, so. Okay, I'm going to bring the clan.
What do you think, Jim?
PM's made a decision. He's chosen you.
Well, I think it should be Tom.
I want to get home tonight. Speak.
That is one of the most insane moments I've ever seen, as a boardroom piece of wobbling indecision.
Well, Nick, Alan and I were like that. Because we couldn't actually believe what we were seeing happening in front of us. What a master stroke, a stroke from Jim, though, to actually talk his
Jim
way
out. Jim is a
out.
Jedi.
Very much in the boardroom, I was pulling little strings. You will not bring me into the boardroom. No, I won't bring you into the boardroom.
These aren't the droids you're looking for.
I'm looking forward to it when exactly you comes to Lord Sugar having a go at Jim, and suddenly you'll suddenly see this look come over, you know, Lord Sugar's face, and suddenly he'll go, I'm fired.
Even if we went, the team leader has spoken, Glenn, at the end of the discussion, and respect what Daddy said, and those are the rules, right? It was also pretty weird that Liam went back to the house, he tried to spin it, tried to make out that this was a plan all along, but was correctly called out by Glenn.
I initially had Jim up in the fire line.
Yes, he's brilliant.
I had to quickly switch tactics, so I brought Glenn in.
You suddenly changed your mind, I'm like, you big whip.
You were a chicken. You bottled it, mate.
I'm telling you that for free.
Oh,
and who is that shadowy figure in the background? Glenn, during all that. Because we're not trying to editorialise here. We're not saying, you know, but there was something about the mind control, and also just in that moment there was the wink. Do you know anyone in business who's done that kind of, who has that kind of control of that? The Kaiser Soze-ish type of way?
I've worked for a number of them, yeah, and I've worked with a number of them. And, it, you know, it's, there are all kind of people within business who exert that control. Sometimes the finance director, sometimes the CEO, sometimes the chairman. You've got to be able to deal with them all.
I have a soft spot for the nerd of the group, Tom, this year, who is our inventor.
Temperature on this day. It will tell you the temperature in London of this day exactly a year ago. A traffic light.
Just having traffic lights, or?
Yeah. I didn't really think it through much more than that.
Because if you put the two together, you can have an app that tells you what the traffic light was doing on this day a year ago.
That's what you've always wanted to know, though, isn't it? Exactly what the temperature was a year ago today. Often you've been wandering along going, oh, if only I had... Oh, I really want to know. Maybe 2 years ago, I know, but a year ago, that would be...
You know, God, is this a softer winter than it was? I know, with Tom's app, we can find out. Oh, no, it's exactly the same. Oh, shut up.
The thing about him, though, and it's true, he is a genuinely nice person. And actually, he's a clever guy, and he's a details guy, and I think he's one to watch.
OK.
Yeah, definitely.
What do you think, Andrew? You've only seen him a little bit of him.
I like him, and I think that, you know, he's got ideas, and I think you want people who've got ideas and are prepared to pitch them in.
OK. The focus is back on you, Alex, now as we find out what Lord Sugar and your former colleagues had to say about you.
Now, Alex never seems to do anything. Always sits in the background, always waiting, you know, strategically to let everybody else do the stuff and so that he's not going to be culpable.
He's a wee bit quiet, he's a bit backward in coming forward.
He's a little bit out of his depth, feeling uncomfortable about certain aspects, and I believe he's a bit of a one-trick pony.
Alex is probably, for me, the weakest that we've got within the team.
Yeah, this process is about me going into business with somebody. I don't go into business with passengers. That's why I fired Alex.
OK, Alex, what can you take from this?
Obviously, I went in with a clear set of tactics and I can admit they didn't work. And ultimately, that's why I'm here now and not weeks down the line, but that's the way it goes.
And what exactly was those tactics? Because you said that you were going to do something, in fact, for the, you know, you were going to make sure you got in there, and then you appeared to do very little apart from put on a Welsh farmer's hat and carry a walking stick. What was the tactic?
I think that I always knew the first few weeks was going to be tricky because you've got 16 bodies flying around. Apart from really the PM, there weren't going to be many people who'd make a massive impact. And once you've got rid of, say, a few people in the first few weeks, there's then maybe more of a chance to grab the process and go for it. So I think everyone, to a degree, in the first task, for example, wanted to kind of slide under the radar and just make it through to week two. And anyone who says otherwise is probably not telling you the truth. And then it's just a question of how long you can get through. And then, obviously, the real work begins. But in this case, it wasn't to be.
You've got to admire the honesty of that, anyway.
I think, equally, you've got to accept that this is a show full of integrity. There are no tactics. You can't pretend to be one person when you're actually somebody else. You can't hide away in the hope of floating on through to the next task. What you see in this show is what you do, and that's what you get.
Andrew, this year's prize is to start up a business. I mean, that's always a difficult thing to do, not necessarily just in this current climate. For Carrefour and Warehouse, I mean, what difficulties did you face?
Well, I would have wished that we could have started with £250,000. I think when Charles first set up the business, he started with £6,000. And in the early days, we had to get... The most important thing was to get people to cross the street to come to your business rather than someone else's and to really differentiate yourself. And it was really hard, and it was really hard. And some days you didn't know whether you could meet the payroll. But every day you had to fight for the people and the employees that were there and be different and be innovative. And I think that the big thing that has made our business the success is innovation and never giving up. And when we've grown it now from, you know, one country into 10 countries and a multinational business, it's the same wherever you are.
Like the boys, the girls got carried away in the recording studio.
Anything that's a sound would do.
Women.